food and in control. What do you think, oh my God? What people's heads are wrong? And wrong. You are like a robot. It's metal brain for road. You tried to take this far. Before the head explodes. No, no, explode. Just like the fighting fighter, let's rush through the street. You dance like a marionette, straight into the symphony. Just like the fighting fighter, let's guys, hello guys, I decided to put my outro in the beginning of the video this time. Because I thought to myself, how many people watch all my video? Not so many. I mean, my mother. So Rami made a new video about racism. He will accuse Piers Morgan and this lady for being racist.
Yay.
Israel has assassinated a senior Hamas leader in a Beirut drone strike that threatens a major escalation in the war on Gaza. In Beirut's southern suburbs of Deir, he's a deputy leader of Hamas's political wing and founder of his militant operations in the occupied West Bank. I would say it's a jolly good thing that this man is no longer alive. I say well done to Israel, or whoever else is going to claim that they carried out this airstrike. Joining me right now to discuss this is Dr.
Bro, these people are so happy when Arabs die. Like, they're so happy when Arabs die. Who were the other six that were killed? That was 1 out of 7. And why is she so happy? Why is it a jolly good thing that these people died? What the heck is wrong with these people?
What? No. What did you just say right now? The second in command, leader of Hamas, was assassinated. And you say what exactly? Let me...
Bro, these people are so happy when Arabs die.
These people are so happy when Arabs die, Arabs in general. And you are talking about the second in command of Hamas after 7/10. So according to you, that is just a random Arab killed because of his race. And then you say, what's wrong with these people? What is wrong with you, Rami? That is the real question.
Bro, these people are so happy when Arabs die. Like, they're so happy when Arabs die. Who were the other six that were killed? That was 1 out of 7. And why is she so happy? Why is it a jolly good thing that these people died? What the heck is wrong with these people?
You ask, why is a good thing when Hamas senior leaders die? Let me think. That's a hard one. I don't know, to tell you the truth. It's very hard for me to answer this question.
Like, they're so happy when Arabs die. Who were the other six that were killed? That was 1 out of 7. And why is she so happy? Why is it a jolly good thing that these people died?
Barghouti, he is leader of the Palestinian National Initiative and a member of the Palestinian Parliament. Good afternoon.
I love this guy, by the way.
It's a good thing when terrorist leaders are assassinated, isn't it?
What kind of an intro is that? Hey, Arab guy, are you as happy as I am that this terrorist is dead? Why do they always start with such loaded questions?
Because she wants to expose that this guy is a terrorist sympathizer like you.
No, it is not, because they are not terrorist leaders. And I am so surprised that you are encouraging the assassination of political people.
Okay, with one question, exposed. Exposed.
Encouraging the assassination of people.
Let me answer, please. You are encouraging the violation of international law. Not only Israel is assassinating a Palestinian leader and provoking a reaction for sure, but more than that, they are doing that on the land of another country, in Lebanon.
That is as stupid as claiming USA had no right to kill Bin Laden in Afghanistan after 9/11. Lebanon provides safe haven to terrorists, so Israel has every right to attack Lebanon to eliminate these terrorists. If Lebanon doesn't extradite Hamas terrorists to Israel or prosecute mass murderers, in other words, then it's a rogue state and an enemy combatant to Israel. And no international law applies here. Okay.
Israel went into another country and killed somebody, and yes, that would provoke a reaction. Did you make the same comments about the October 7th massacre? Did you also condemn Hamas for entering Israeli territory, provoking?
So she's just very slyly moves away from the fact that she is enticing a war crime by basically commending Israel for assassinating political people. And she moves away from that and very expertly, by the way, jumps back to October 7th, which is their favorite subject.
Rami, in what strange universe, in what parallel dimension, a terrorist who just murdered 1,400 people and as we speak holds hostage children and even babies is a political person? In what universe? Maybe Bin Laden is also a political person. How about the representative of ISIS? Are you serious, my friend? What is wrong with you people? That is the real question, Rami. And she mentions 7/10 because in this case, Hamas, under the orders of your political people, entered another state and assassinated civilians, yet alone gave justice against terrorists in a rogue state, as Israel did, in other words. So how is that irrelevant? That is totally relevant, exposing the double standards of this doctor.
Reaction from Israel and killing innocent people?
Do you condemn that Israel is occupying us since 1960?
Look at her face. She's so confused. She's like, I don't know if she's trying to think of a response or if she's trying to act like what he's saying is idiotic. Because if she acts like what he's saying is idiotic, then the audience is just supposed to assume that it is idiotic. But he's actually posing a very good point. He's saying, listen, Lebanon is a separate country that has nothing to do with Israel. Israel dropped bombs within their land to get someone who is a member of another country.
Rami, you are idiots. That's the simple facts of reality. Look now what you are saying. You present things without any context. Citizen X drop a bomb to a different country to kill another citizen X. Why you don't say the other details? The mere fact that you avoid to say the details shows that deep inside, even you understand how idiotic is what you're saying. So, the person Israel killed was a Hamas senior leader that orchestrated the attacks on 7th of October. That is the context, Rami. And if you give this context, then your moral quantum changes. It's not just random citizen X in a random country X was bombed for reasons unknown.
Whereas when Hamas broke out of the concentration camp they were in Gaza, they were breaking out of a place that was occupied illegally by Israel and attacking the people that are illegally occupying them, which the UN has affirmed their right to do.
The UN affirms Hamas the right to do the 7/10 attacks. This is what you just said. Rami, have you ever considered the possibility that Islam just makes you dumb, my friend? Every word you say is, what can I say, my friend? Imagine, Rami, every word you say is dumber than the dumbest statement I ever made in my life. Okay. The UN gives the right of Hamas to do 7/10. Really? Really? Is this confirmed, or there is also a debate about that?
Back in the 80s, the UN General Assembly reaffirmed the Palestinians' right to armed struggle. Why is she so surprised? Maybe she's racist.
Maybe she's racist. Mm. Rami, let me tell you something. Okay. No race is superior than any other race. That's a fact. But you Islamists are the N word in the mind. Okay. Islam makes you the N word in the mind. Rami, you just said that the attacks on 7 of October is an armed struggle, not a war crime. And you claimed that the UN agrees with you. Is this true, Rami? Or you are just dumb, my friend? And how ironic, with the same breath, you accuse Israel of war crimes when targeting terrorists, civilians are killed.
I don't know. Maybe it's not okay when Arab people fight back against oppression, and it's only okay when white people fight back.
Do you condemn that Israel is practicing ethnic cleansing against Palestinian people since 75 years? Do you condemn that Israel has evicted 70% of the Palestinian people from their land, erasing to the ground 520 Palestinian towns and villages?
Okay. This is the liberation versus Islamist supremacy argument. The Palestinian conflict started and it sustained because of Islamist uncompromising radical ideas. All the political attempts to solve this issue fell short on the toxicity of political Islam. The Palestinian struggle will be in the future a just cause or a humanitarian struggle or a liberation struggle if the Palestinians get rid of political Islam. At this moment, the actors behind the Palestinian so-called liberation struggle are Iranian Islamic Revolution ideals and Sunni type of Muslim Brotherhood ideas. So it's not a liberation struggle, it's a struggle to eliminate Israel. It's not, therefore, Israel or the world to blame that Palestinians trust Islamists like Rami for their well-being. Okay, so when a Palestinian sees Mohammed Hijab on Piers Morgan and claps, ah, bravo! Okay, the result of that is what you see now. Okay, when you trust complete idiots like Rami and Mohammed Hijab for your well-being, this is what you get. That's simple. That is how the world works. If you see a cliff and you decide that, oh, Mohammed Hijab is right, I will fly, and you run over the cliff, you will fall down because of gravity and you will break your leg. That's the nature of this world. So it's not our fault for you having a toxic mental disease as your government.
Condemn that.
I'm sorry. She's like, okay.
Okay.
What does that mean? Let me go back and see that again.
Do you condemn that Israel is practicing ethnic cleansing against Palestinian people since 75 years? Do you condemn that Israel has evicted 70...
She actually looks shocked. Like, she actually looks like she doesn't know what she's going to say.
80% of the Palestinian people from their land, erasing to the ground 500...
She's blinking so much as well. I'm not a freaking... an expert on micro expressions or facial expressions, but I'm pretty sure when someone blinks that much, there's something wrong going on up here. She's trying to, like, she's firing those neurons trying to figure out how to respond at this point.
Mustafa, I am so surprised that you are so encouraging
fascist
behavior.
We've only got a short time. We can't do the last 75 years history. I asked you a specific question. Did you condemn?
I will not answer your question till you tell me whether you condemn the atrocities that are happening in Gaza. Three war crimes. The war crime of ethnic cleansing.
So you're not going to answer my question. Punishment.
And the war crime.
I'm not sure you understand how interviews work.
I swear, this is basically the female version of Piers Morgan. Like, they are two apples from the same tree.
Two things about that. Firstly, the mere fact that you think she's the controversial and you are the common sense shows how Islam made you mentally handicapped. Nobody cares at this point how many times Palestinians rejected a two-state solution, how many times Palestinians attacked Israel and they lost land, and how many times your evil mental disease martyred Palestinians for a last cause, and we came here. But we are now here, and Piers Morgan represents common sense. It's not a coincidence. Pro-Palestinians activists are Islamists, radical leftists, and the far right. Okay, all the extreme ideologues are with Palestine.
And I would not be surprised if they went to freaking interviewing school together and they were trained on this exact thing. I'm not going to respond to your relevant point that shows that my question is a loaded question and should not have been phrased in the way that it was phrased. So I'm just going to go and repeat the question to bring it back there. It's really weird that in interviews, you can frame the entire discussion just by staying on a point and refusing to move off of it. And in some cases, it just works and you end up looking good.
Rabbi, people like to discuss the current days, okay? They don't want to go to where you want to go, okay? You want to go to history, but this is a news channel. They don't care about what happened in 1947. Now, in the platforms you discuss history, you get decimated, my friend. You get decimated. Have you seen any debate with history with a Muslim and a Zionist? You get decimated. You get embarrassed. You cannot say anything. Israel Advocacy Movement made you a comedy at speakers' corners every time. Ben Shapiro, let's see.
Which part of Israel is occupied Palestine?
All of Israel.
There we go. There we go. There we go. So what you're calling for is the obliteration of the state of Israel, and all of this is just a cover for that. I appreciate your time. I'm just going to ask you the last question, the same question I asked her. Which part of Palestine is occupied?
The entirety of Palestine, but
there we go.
I'm not
Thank
calling
you once
for
again.
The destruction of Jews.
I appreciate you expressing your full genocidal intent for the Jewish people living between the rivers.
Why is it genocidal to call for a state that is not...
The occupation of Palestine.
The whole thing, right? Just to be clear?
The entirety of Palestine.
Thank you.
You may accuse me of genocide if you wish. That is not my position.
Sure. But and I will, but go ahead.
That you have phrased constantly and consistently, and it's quite a popular Zionist talking point, is the fact that the Arabs have rejected peace every time it was offered to them. Now, I would like, of course, there's been multiple times where peace has been offered, so let's discuss some of them. You have lied multiple times. I can continue if you would wish, but I would like to ask you the question. When you lie, do you feel shame?
Okay, so... on the table, the Jews accepted it, the Arabs rejected it, so you did not actually
David
undermine my case.
In his diary,
should be no deal in
David
the first place.
In his diary states...
Hold on. I listened to your whole bullshit history for like 5 minutes here, so at least let me respond to it. Your entire claim is that the Arabs did not reject peace, and then in your own disquisition, you admitted that the Arabs rejected the Peel Commission plan, which was a separation between the Jews and the Arabs, which gave an extraordinary amount of land to the Arabs. The Arabs then rejected the peace partition plan proposed by the United Nations in 1947. They then proceeded to reject the Oslo Accords in 93. After that, they rejected the Y River Accords in 98. They rejected Ehud Barak's very generous offer in 2000. They rejected Olmert's very generous offer in 2008. Every single peace deal that has been proposed by Israel or anyone else has been rejected by the Arabs for a very simple reason, which was the very first question I asked you. You do not accept that there should be a Jewish state anywhere in this region. So as long as that's the case, there's literally nothing to argue about. You cannot simultaneously maintain the position there should not be a Jewish state anywhere in the region and then tell me that I'm wrong when I say that the Arabs will not accept a two-state solution. You yourself say that there should not be a two-state solution.
That is what happens every time you discuss history with a Zionist. This is more or less every debate I've watched. So, from where you drive this confidence that history will be kind with you? First of all, from where you get the confidence that you will ever win any argument ever? From where? For example, in this video, it was... You made errors every 5 seconds. So, if you talk about history, you will make errors every 7 seconds. What is this confidence? So, you are confident. If we talked about history, the errors I will make won't be every 5 seconds, it will be every 7 seconds. You cannot win anything, my friend. You are too dumb to win anything. Islam has made your... brain a mashed potato. You cannot win any argument ever in any subject. So when you obfuscate to history, you think you are doing something. Anyway, thank you very much, people. Thank you.